specifically say an apology for Kevin not being here today. And like many things with G4, this network wouldn't exist without you guys. So please give all of yourselves a round of applause. Yeah.
And so seeing this is honestly is amazing.
I mean, he should have been specific with the name.
Shout out, I have friends in your business since I was like a teenager. Is Patrick in here? Hi.
Hello.
Hi,
Patrick.
This is no time to rekindle old flames, Gina.
Amazing to me to see people talking about video games on television. Love that guy.
She doesn't know about G4. She got the job.
25.
She'll admit that.
Yeah, so imagine that. Yeah. At 5 years old, we were tight. No, I unfortunately have not had a real history with you boys. Kevin roasts me every day. Because I refuse to watch any old G4 stuff. Because I was like, I want this to be like the new, I don't really want to be influenced by the old G4.
You want to put your personality into what's going forward.
Sure.
Yeah, but the template that worked.
I mean, I liked the idea of it. I liked everything that it stood for. And then I was like, I would love to just kind of be that new voice. So I try not to look too far back, so I'm not influenced by the decisions from before. But man, if I was watching it, I'd love it. Yeah, so that's my experience.
Yeah. And the thing is, I tried to do that on my own, and I still miss it.
Still miss it.
I don't think it's something that you see immediately or that you're trying to
decipher at the time, but Kevin Pereira is an incredible host, like one of the best that I've ever seen.
The first
He was the guy for me, and so the chance that we get to work with him is like, I don't know, we keep saying it's unbelievable, you know, words, but literally it is a dream come true to be able to be on set with him. Yeah. But he's like, not the king, I'm the king though.
He is the king.
Yeah.
Episode 11, we're so for me, this can sound super weird. I am a fan of Adam Sessler for all the wrong reasons that people would be a fan of him for. He is very loud, and I am the exact opposite of that. He is very unapologetic. I say sorry every 10 seconds. He is very committed to his strong personality and choices, and I feel like I need to backtrack every 30 seconds. So for me, kind of idolizing him and working with him now in a professional way is just super exciting because a part of him really rubs off on me and having to be confident in my choices and working with my team. At the same time, like, because there is a generational gap between some of the hosts on X-Play and Sessler, we kind of rub off on him too, and that's always fun. The parts that you guys don't even see is when we're in rehearsals or filming commercial stuff for TV and we make him laugh. And hearing Adam Sessler laugh is such a joyous thing, to be able to make him laugh on camera. And that's like my secret goal, is that if I'm with him, I'm like, how do I make Adam Sessler laugh in front of everyone? If I can make him laugh, then I can make all of you laugh. That's my goal that I try to aim for, you know, with Adam.
I don't know, I'm hoping I'll say this here, if they're not speaking to me, but I was a massive fan of Kevin.
Aww.
He has such a distinct voice, and his grading, the rhythm that he does, is something that a lot of viewers from back then know, and to be able to work with both of them is incredible. The first thing that people actually ever put me on when he first hired me was with Adam, just from the screen, and I remember his camera popped up, and I really got struck. Like, it was incredible. And then meeting him in person at the beach house, he was a nice person. He became like an uncle. If you need help with anything, let me know. And then Kevin, like they said, Kevin, I've been doing this for, Kevin is by far the best host I've ever met. He is so good, he's so fast. It is very hard to make him speechless, unless I say something partially virtual that I can just can't. It's super fun.
You just watch the window shut down, go down here.
Every night, and here he was on TV, you know, and so
only other person I would say, I've worked with Norm MacDonald, and Norm MacDonald is the, you know, and rest in peace, Norm, but he's the other one.
God bless Norm!
Kevin is just like, you think he's super fast, and you think he's smart, and you see what he does, and he elevates everyone around, and you see that on TV, but you have no idea how much deeper it goes when you're actually there on set with him. He's 12 steps ahead. He's the Bobby Fischer of hosts. He's always figuring out ways to keep the broadcast going, make you seem and feel funnier. And besides him and Adam Sessler, you know, same. This is a guy I've watched since I was a kid. It hasn't worn off the fact that these people are people we get to interact with on a daily basis. And I am an Olivia Munn fan,
too. Yeah, keep in mind that the reason why we didn't say other hosts is because we don't get to work with them. We get to work with Adam and Kevin. So to really see them in action, especially Kevin, it's like watching a master work every single day. And you know how he loves pickleball? It's like playing pickleball with him. We love seeing him go at it, and it inspires us to play with him and go hard.
I remember the first episode of the tech that we did when we launched, right before we went live, Kevin was on the sidelines. You know, he was jumping, he was prepping himself, and he was pumping himself up, and all of us kind of looking at him, and he was like, oh crap, this is happening, we have Kevin.
Yeah.
And we got pretty emotional. I got scared, but it was
a lot of energy.
So I feel like you had an emotional day.
I did, I felt so alive.
Yeah, I thought it was because you broke up with your boyfriend.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right.
It was fun.
So we're coming in on about a year since we all met each other and started at the Beach House, and we can now see what the network is shaping into, but how do you want to continue to put more of yourself into the network, and what do you want to do with the future of G4 from here on out?
More fresh ink. Yesterday I was shooting on the floor and I had like five people stop me and specifically say that they're really digging the fresh ink stuff, and that means more to me than just about every other thing I've done recently. So thank you, and the goal is for me to feel like G4 should be a place where people who are into comics or thinking about getting into comics can come and learn more. And so I would love to do more. And I'd love to do some real programs.
Thank you.
the girls.
Going to be my greatest challenge.
Oh, yet. Okay, now the
How weird?
Like fighting game weird.
Never send a boy to do a god's job.
Behind the camera, he was
really quick with his hand. Black Lung is the guy next to you I saw. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm glad you guys decide. Whoever raised their hand first between you, because you look like friends.
Show the answer.
Five.
What?
Five.
Did you see five?
Yeah.
Cool, because he just won the backpack.
Just to help you guys out, we don't do points, say, the points on X play, and also the answer is going to be either 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5.
Thank you for helping me with that. Gina, what's the final prize?
The final prize. Something I came up with myself. I worked very hard on this. Cassie?
A backpack.
You mean like you bit the head off? Yeah, the one that I put in my mouth.
The paint is bomb on that hallway.
Games that I make up and things like that, just being around all of these incredible people
I sometimes say things that I mean as a joke, and it gets lost in a lot of people's. I'll say something nice, and it comes out meaner than I thought, and then I'm like, I just keep doing it over and over again. It's part of my character work, you guys. I'm just trying to get really mad all the time. I think what I didn't say was is that, like, I learned how to communicate more effectively as much as I can with the team, because I'm kind of like the phase walker that goes back between attacking and X play fairly often. So, what I do on X play sometimes affects attack and vice versa. So, like, learning how to communicate with everyone is the thing that I just always hope that I can do clearly. So I always say yes to things, but sometimes I say yes to something that will impact someone's producing schedule or how they think about it. So I just really learned to just over-communicate and apologize for who's doing what I think.
That's
flawless.
He's flawless.
That's not a bunch of bots. It's really cool. because we love what we're doing and the fact that you guys are entertained in the least bit by our shenanigans, it makes us so happy. And so thank you for being a part of that. Thank you for supporting us, because it means the world to us.
And those people are, you know, maybe they're hate watching or maybe they stop watching, but like you guys are still giving us a chance and sticking it with us, and we really appreciate that. You have no idea. Every person who's this weekend who said, hey, I want G4, who is here in the room with us right now in the Discord, like, you guys have no idea how much energy and creativity is filling us up right now. We're back to LA and we're ready to go to make more stuff for you guys, so thank you.